It's me, Gino.
Hello there. How y'all doing? Hey, welcome to a very special Gino's Thing of the Day. Why so special? It's 4th of July, silly. Come on, you knew that, right? Anyway, people are saying, hey, Gino, you got something patriotic to show us for today? So, of course I do. Don't let it be said that Gino's not patriotic. So, hey, how's this for patriotic? Boom! We've got two extremely patriotic Uncle Sam duckies. This one's really cool with the goatee, but this one just is the total package, you know? Isn't he cool? He's from hell. Cool figure. Hey, the other day, we were in the line at the store, my wife and I, and we're watching, and there's this little boy with the you know, his mom that's in the cart ahead of us in the checkout lane. So, you know, just a nice, cute little boy, and kind of engaged in conversation. Just tell him about the 4th of July, because he, you know, obviously saw it on, like, their magazines in the checkout, and obviously knew about fireworks and all that. Let's tell him about, you know, 4th of July and what it meant, and our independence, and talking about liberty and that he was free, and then he got all indignant and said, no, he said, I'm not free, I'm poor. So, it was cute. I don't know, maybe he had to be there. You know, when I was in the Navy on a med cruise one summer in July, guys would ask, hey, does France have the 4th of July? Like, of course they do, silly. It's right after the 3rd of July, right before the 5th of July. Anyway, actually, they've got what's called Bastille Day. It's a lot like our 4th of July. They also call it Le 14 Juillet, which means, get this, the 14th of July. Sound familiar? Anyway, you know, that just gave me pause to reflect and, you know, about our freedom and our independence and all that stuff. And I started thinking, I'm like, well, what were those first Americans like? I'm like, well, they were like ants. See, lived in colonies. But people say, Gino, you know, you're French, though. Is your connection? Were your people around? I'm like, of course they were. Oh, I come from a very long, long patriotic line of people. My my great-great-great-grandfather, well, he fought alongside Napoleon. And then my great-great-great-grandfather was, he fought with the French, of course, World War I in the trenches. My great-great-grandfather was, that's right, he's on the beaches of Normandy. And you get thinking about it, it's like, man, my relatives just can't get along with anybody, can they? But, yeah, so it's, and you look at that, it's been like more than 200 years now, and we, you know, defeated the British Army in the Revolutionary War, won our independence, and, you know, how did that all start? Of course, we had to sign the Declaration of Independence and say, we are independent, and people say, oh, where did they sign the Declaration of Independence? Like, well, obviously, at the bottom. But, yeah, and then our forefathers beat the British Army. I'm like, wow, the whole British Army. Those are four badass dudes, especially for dads. But, of course, the war started. It was Paul Revere's famous ride. You know, people are like, wow, why did Paul Revere ride all the way from Boston down to Lexington? I say, oh my God, man, the horse is way too heavy to carry all that way. Hey, you know another famous iconic scene? The painting, the very famous painting of Washington crossing the Delaware. You know, the one he's standing up in the prow of the boat, all that, and just wonderful. But you look at it, and it's like, man, these men just look so heroic, so inspired. Like, God, I wish I could have been there and seen and heard and been a part of that. Like, obviously, it's actually very little known, but it is recorded what Washington said to his men that day before they crossed the Delaware. He said, men, get in the boat. So they crossed the Delaware, and of course, that led to what? Well, we had a flag, right? So, yeah, we got a flag. It's, like, hey, what's red, white, and blue? You're right. Our new flag and a very sad candy cane. But anyways, Hey, speaking of that, what's red, white, and blue, and green? That's right, patriotic turtles. Of course, after the flag, well, we had to have a song, so we got, you know, Star Spangled Banner. One of the most widely known songs in America, for sure, right? Oh, say, can you see? Like, everybody knows that opening line. A lot of people forget the end. Play ball! But, yeah. Hey, that's been Gino's thing of the day. Glad you could be here with me. And, you know what? Next time, someone gets you backed up against the corner and they ask you, they say, hey, why are there no knock-knock jokes about America? You're looking dead square right in the eye. And you say, because freedom rings. Loves you, people. Loves you. Later.